Well, hello. It's Joan. And today is Throwaway Thursday. Don't normally do it on Thursdays, do I? I'm usually the Tidy Up Tuesday gal. And I wanted to share with you today that today is Throwaway Thursday. Monday's Make Your Bed Monday. Tuesday is Tidy Up Tuesday. Wednesday's Wreck Havoc Wednesday. And Thursday's Throwaway Thursday. So you have to realize all of those days. I actually have 7 days that help you know what to do each day in the tidy up world. I'm Joan Silva. I loved helping people discover the joy of tidying up, and I'm known as the Tidy Up Gal and the Queen of Clean. So welcome here. I appreciate you joining me. Thank you, Susan. Good morning to you too. And Nora, thank you for joining me as well. I decided to hop on here on Thursday. I did give a little warning on Tuesday I wouldn't have a Facebook Live that day, and I might do Wednesday, which is Wreck Havoc Wednesday, Wreck Havoc, or Throwaway Thursday. But today is Throwaway Thursday. Let's dive into that. So, the topic today is before you organize, you toss. I've spent years organizing stuff I don't need. And that went from household goods, from clothing, to shoes, to jewelry and accessories, to hair products, to decorative items like you see behind me. It could have been pantry items, stuff in the fridge, although I tend to keep a pretty lean and mean refrigerator. I like fresh and I tend to toss or eat pretty regularly what's in there. Don't tend to overbuy. But today, let's talk about what we can throw away. You get to decide. What is it that you think? The one thing, just one that you'd like to throw away today. What is that? Could it be excess pens? As I open my drawer here, I actually did this a while back and I only have a few pens, a highlighter, an ink pen, a marking pen. That's all in the drawer. And I do have a few other areas where I store backups. So, might be you get rid of a few pens and some pencils. I was thinking about the pantry today. That seemed to be an area that a lot of people tend to hide because it's in a cupboard. It might be a walk-in pa type pantry. It could be a very small cupboard. It could be several cabinets. I heard something on, I don't know if any of you have ever watched the documentary that's Fat, Sick, and Almost Dead. The documentary on its basic premises, eating micronutrients and doing it via juice and fruit juice and eating fruits and vegetables. And one of the things that they spoke about in that, Dr. Furman was actually interviewed in that particular documentary. There's two of them, by the way. Part one was a number of years ago, then he did a follow-up 5 years later. And he said that why do we put right in front of us the boxes of cereal? So I don't happen to think cereal is particularly healthy. And neither do they because it's a macronutrient, which the body really doesn't need or very little of it. We need micronutrients, which are fruits and vegetables, nuts, seeds, things like that. And we want to be sure that that's what's prominent in our pantry or our fridge because our brains will register the thing that we see there most frequent. We open the cabinet, we open the fridge, there it is, there it is, there it is. And without realizing it, then we want it and we eat it. Personally, I tend to get rid of those things. If they're not healthy for me, I have a tendency not to keep them in my pantry. Maybe you'll consider that as well. So, what's that one thing that you might get rid of in your fridge or your pantry today? So, on Throwaway Thursday, what's that one thing? So, let me say hello. Yes, Laurel, thank you for joining me and Suzanne as well. And good morning to you, Laurel. Thank you for saying so. So, those of you who are on here at the moment, can you think of the one area that you'd like to focus even? So, maybe the Throwaway Thursday is in an area, like I mentioned, a pantry, a refrigerator, a cabinet, a drawer. On my Clutter to Tidy Facebook group, which please join me there, it is a community, and I do post on there regularly ideas around tidying up and clutter clearing. And moving towards tidy. And I usually have a daily suggestion, a daily challenge, or a daily idea. Today, excuse me, yesterday was how about a scarf? How about getting rid of some of your scarves? Most of us have way too many wraps, scarves, other things that we aren't using. I realized as I was doing that I had this warm wrap, and today in California, it's a little nippy and chilly out there. It's raining and overcast. Suddenly I was sitting here going, "Ooh, I'm chilly. There's my wrap." I had gone through those the day before. The day before that, on Clutter to Tidy, we talked about getting rid of purses. Maybe it's throwaway purse day or giveaway purse day. So when I say throwaway Thursdays, it could be deep sixing it, or it could be giving it away. You get to decide on that. I'm going to challenge you, though, to not hang on to it in another place in the house. Like a bag, we start to accumulate things, and we put it, in California, in the garage. I'm going to suggest you walk right straight out and put it in the trunk of your car, and as soon as you walk out at the door, you take it to the nearest place that you would give it away to. Because it hangs around, the energy's still there, and the tendency is to hang on to it. So it really was just a quick throwaway Thursday concept today. And a few of you are on here. You haven't actually owned up what you'd like to tidy up and throw away today. Could it be maybe some, I don't know, extra hair products? Could it be something that's in your linen closet? All those towels you don't use, or sheets that don't quite fit. I don't know about you, but I had some that no matter how I struggled with it, the fitted sheet would never stay on. You'd sleep on it, and it was like remaking the whole bed all over again. What's with that? Get rid of those. Why are they folded up still in my linen closet when they just irritate the bejesus out of me? So how about you? Maybe it's your linen closet. The other area that I see a lot is actually the easiest area, surprisingly, is clothing. We have a tendency to buy more and more and more and build up our closets, and we aren't actually wearing but maybe 20% of what's in there. Now, I'm not talking seasonal, because some of us live in areas that are quite chilly, and of course you'll have your winter wardrobe and then your lighter weight spring and summer wardrobe. I get that. I'm not talking about that, because honestly, you could move your winter wardrobe into another area and only have your summer and spring during that season, and you'll still only wear 20% of that. I started looking at that myself. I have some really nice things. And I thought, oh, I'll wear them someday. I call that the someday syndrome. Maybe it's time to get rid of one of those items. Clothing, like I said, is the most, the least challenging. It's the easiest area to do. And some of us are fearful to do the whole closet or the whole thing at once, which means pulling it all out, putting it in a big pile, and then deciding. Our tendency is to kind of just weed out, and we don't recognize we actually have far more still in there because we're doing it sort of piecemeal. The way to really do it is to pull it all the way out, put it in a pile, keep not. And the not could go either in the trash, because some of those clothes are really bad, or they could actually be something like a giveaway. So either one. So what is yours today? Oh, Susan, you said your pantry has no more gluten-containing items for herself. The basic, barely sweet cookies I keep for my grandkids are above my eye level where I forgot about them. Yay, yes. There you go. Because if those little cookies, and I'm not even drawn to sugar, I should say things that are specifically sugar. I mean, obviously there's sugar in many things that I might be eating I'm not aware of, because it changes in the body composition to sugar. But here's the thing, if those little chocolates or cookies or things for other people are right at your focus the minute you open the refrigerator or the pantry, it tells you to eat it. You don't even realize it's actually done that to you. So you actually have to pay attention to where you have it. If you're not going to toss it, then put it where it isn't actually pushing your buttons all the time. So yeah, Susan, you said you just bought a new set of sheets with deeper pockets. The other ones were driving me crazy. The old ones will be donated next week. Yes, amen. Nothing worse. And of course, my hubby and I, if you know, he rolls over, next thing you know, bing, off the corner comes. Or if I roll over, bing, off the corner comes. Nothing makes me crazier than constantly fooling around with the covers, the sheets. Yeah, I like simple. I like easy. So please, please, yes, donate those and get ones that actually work for you. And each one of our mattresses is different. You know, they'll say, oh, yeah, this is perfect for a California King, which is what I have. And they're awful, just awful. So thank you, Susan, for sharing that. And Annie, thank you for joining me. And Suzanne Doty, thank you for joining me. I'd like you to just pick one area today. And that doesn't mean your whole bedroom or your whole closet or your whole pantry, although I do challenge if you want to do that, yay, dive in. Just one thing. So as you open that pantry, because you decided that's the area that bugs you, just pick a couple of things, just a couple of things, and toss them. And we'll have a tendency to think, oh, I'll fix that thing. Yeah, I will use that. When I did my pantry a few months back, I noticed how many gluten-free pre-done packages I had. I'm allergic to gluten. I have celiacs. And one of the things I noticed was the packages just sat in there. I don't particularly like the pre-packaged things. I'm not a cooker. I don't really enjoy baking. A lot of times they were things like cornbreads or things like that, unless I'm going to a gathering and I'm bringing something. And I finally thought, this is crazy. In the trash they went, because I'm telling you, they've been in there a long time. A can of cocoa hadn't used in forever. I thought, well, who in the heck wants this after it's been opened and in there for how long? Spices. There's definitely a time limit on those. Once the lids are open and you have them sitting in there, they lose their resilience. So maybe today's the pantry. Must be. I'm focusing on that. So, welcome, welcome to Throwaway Thursday. If you'd like to join my Facebook group, it's called From Clutter to Tidy with Joan Silva. You can hit it in the search engine. I'll put it in the comments section if you'd like to. And it's a community group where I post challenges. Usually I do my Facebook lives there. Today I chose to do it on my timeline. And the thing is that it helps when you have other people sharing what they've done, how they've handled it, what it is they're doing with their clutter, and some of the ideas, like Susan just mentioned, where she decided to get rid of the fitted sheets that didn't fit and buy the deep pocket ones, or her pantry where she moved her grandchildren's cookies up out of her vision. So when she opened her pantry, it didn't nudge her to eat the cookies. So, Annie, you said yesterday I attacked my pantry. Out went old grains, popcorn, and beans. Yes. There were things in my pantry too, Annie, that even though they might be something you would eventually use, maybe, how long have they been in there? How long have they sat in there? I found that even some of the stuff even had like almost the bag almost had a sticky feel to them. And I'm like, ooh, yuck. So I think that's the thing we have to notice. Is there a deadline on that food? And I don't mean the kind that the store sets on there because that's the sell by date. I'm talking about the actual valuable date. So like spices might be several months, not years, ladies and gents. And we want to get rid of them sooner. We want to refresh them sooner or not replace them at all if we aren't using them. So that's one of the things I also noticed is how many spices I had in there that I never used and I didn't enjoy using. So why would I replace them? So again, Throwaway Thursday with Joan Silva, helping you discover the joys of tidying up. Come join me on From Clutter to Tidy with Joan Silva on a Facebook group, free. You have to ask to join. It is a closed group because we like to share and be safe with each other. And yesterday I had scarves and shawls as one of the challenges. Get rid of one of those and look at whether or not you're using them or not. So you never know what I'll pose there, but please come join me and enjoy your Thursday as you throw away a toss or give away. You can get me at joan@joansilva.com.